What's up, everybody? We're kind of interested in doing a video after the Royal Rumble and for the road to WrestleMania. And there's been a lot of controversial things happen, so we figured we'd go ahead and do a video.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good couple days in the WWE world.
We got Samoa Joe. He made his debut. Seth Rollins got hurt all in the same
segment. Seth Rollins got hurt on Samoa Joe's debut. So, could be considered who's the top guy in the company gets hurt.
Yeah.
Right before WrestleMania.
He might miss WrestleMania again, right? Like, from what I saw.
We don't know the extent of the injury yet, so I mean...
Somebody look that up. I want to see, like, what his injury looks like.
Well, I just actually looked it up, and there's nothing...
Nobody knows anything yet.
Yeah, MRI or whatever.
It's too early.
They probably know, and they probably don't want to say anything, really.
I've seen a couple people say it's part of the storyline.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Oh, that would be cool. I just thought that was so dumb, like, he got hurt with them.
I hope it's part of the storyline. I hope it's storyline, but you never know.
I mean, I only watched the first, like, minute or two, because I was just like, oh, yeah, typical, like, in the WWE, somebody's getting beat up, you know, walk away. I knew it was about to end.
I saw
him get thrown into the barricade, and I was like, that looked, like, a little bit hard. Like, he did it three times.
I didn't see anything that looked knee injury related, though. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't see anything that looks like it hurt the knee. I mean, I might be wrong. I might not be.
It was probably more of him planting his foot the wrong way, and then Samoa Joe probably pulled him. Some of those knee injuries are really awkward.
Yeah.
Like, Triple H, when he tore his quad the second time, didn't really look like anything.
Let's just hope it's nothing serious, you know what
I mean? But, I mean, it kind of sucks, because that was, like, this is the first WrestleMania in a while that I was, like, they actually are building, like, a bunch of good rivalries.
Yeah.
It's usually kind of, like, they throw it together last minute, you know, this guy and this guy. You know, like, think about, like, Rollins' last match at WrestleMania, because he missed last year, 2 years before. They kind of just threw him in there with Orton, and they're like, all right, nobody really cares because he's cashing in, so who cares?
Yeah. Well, let's run through the Royal Rumble real quick. You were kind of not wrong. You said something about everybody's forgetting about Orton, but Orton ended up winning.
I was just like, everybody was promoted, Brock, Goldberg, Taker, all of those guys were promoted, and then a couple other guys, I was like, Baron Corbin, Braun Strowman, Jericho, I'm like, they haven't said anything about Orton, I wouldn't be surprised if he won, all I said.
When we made that Facebook Live video, before the video started, I'm like, I'm totally picking Orton, and then last minute I was like, Undertaker, and I'm like, Undertaker. God.
Well, I mean, that was the way they were building. I mean, it seemed like it was going to be an Undertaker win. I mean...
Well, I knew that, like, they built all those guys up, and I figured one of them wouldn't win, but I didn't think it'd be, like, for sure Orton. I was like, I could see it.
Yeah. So we had Orton. Orton won the Rumble. Kevin Owens retained. And John Cena... I'm sure he's not watching, but congratulations, John Cena. Tying Ric Flair's 16-time... world champion. I'm not sure.
I think they should have waited till WrestleMania if he did do it. But
that's how I felt. Yeah. I feel if you're going to pull a trigger that big, you pull it on your biggest stage. But, I mean, I'm not WWE creative, so maybe I don't
know. I'm interested in seeing how they're going to, like, do the Orton Styles Cena title picture.
Well, I don't know if you watched SmackDown or not last night, because I know you did. I know you missed a little bit.
Yeah, I just recorded it. I was going to watch it later.
They're building a pretty good feud. I don't know if you want me to say anything or not since you haven't seen it.
I don't really care. I'm just going to watch a recording, fast forward through it.
It looked like they started a Styles and Ambrose Intercontinental feud.
I heard a little bit about that. I thought it was just a match, but I didn't know they were... That kind of sucks.
It ended controversial, so it looks like it might go on, maybe.
I hope not. Because what about his rematch? Right? I hate how WWE does that. Sometimes, like, a guy will get his rematch, and sometimes they're like, all right, this feud's over. He's not getting his rematch.
It's going to be interesting, because they're both in the Elimination Chamber next month. So is Orton.
They can't count that as a rematch, though.
No.
They probably will, just because they're tired of that.
I think that'll kind of settle the feuds, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I don't know, probably not.
Braun Strowman on Raw, he wants a title shot against Kevin Owens. He said since he helped Kevin Owens retain, that Kevin Owens owes him a title match. So that'll be interesting. I don't think he'll win it.
He won't.
He has, like, no charisma on the mic. It's horrible. But,
it's not like the typical big guy character for him. It's not like Undertaker and Kane. It's like, what is he? Like, he used to be in the Wyatt family. He's big. There's no character. You don't even need charisma, but they need, like, some type of character.
You gotta have some kind of basis to base
this off. He doesn't have any, like, he has kind of a, you know, generic theme song, and, like, he doesn't wear anything.
Just comes out screaming. Particular. That's all it is.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he doesn't. They need to build him something. They need to have, like, some backstory or something.
With how athletic he is, there's definitely potential. You know what I mean?
It's not even his fault. It's just the booking and the creative. They have nothing for it.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how that plays out. I don't know what's going to happen with Reigns.
They'll figure something for Reigns. Everybody probably won't be too happy about it.
Reigns and Undertaker, they were having a...
They kind of foreshadowed it. that's what I was about to touch on. Yeah,
because
Reigns eliminated Undertaker and people were pissed, man. People were mad.
Then he gave him like a stare down and all.
Yeah, it was weird.
Yeah.
Do you enjoy the pay-per-view? You don't really watch many WWE.
I don't watch much. I'm trying to get back into it because I stopped watching.
Long time ago.
It was getting so stale for me.
But it's getting pretty good. I mean,
yeah, I love the Rumble. I'm definitely gonna. I'm gonna get WWE Network. That way, I can like watch. Cause I have to go to bed early and stuff. So I'm gonna start.
You gonna come over for Mania?
Oh yes.
All right.
And Elimination.
Any of our subscribers want to come over for Mania? Just let us know.
Yeah, if you happen to be in the Charlotte area and you're not a creep, let us know. I think it's... Lesnar's one of our favorite guys, me and Patrick.
Yeah, I was about to say, what about
Lesnar's
Lesnar?
One of our favorite guys.
I don't want to say it, but I have to... I'm butthurt. That's the only word I can use. The way they have been booking him...
I
know that they need to get him a legitimate, like... Because they let him go on this Reign of Terror for 2 years. They let him beat Undertaker, and they let him beat...
They got to knock him down somehow.
They have to have somebody be credible. I get that. But... Basically, what they're doing is they have this guy. They built all their resources go into him for about 3 years, and then they let this old 50-year-old guy who never really could wrestle more than like 10 minutes, even in his prime, come out and just beat him. And I'm like, okay, he beat him once. They have to have a respected contender, and then he did it again at the Rumble.
They did it
at WrestleMania 20. Well, he's 3-0 over Brock Lesnar. What are they gonna
do? We were talking about when somebody comes in the Rumble, they usually go in there and they just destroy everybody real quick, and then it kind of calms down.
Yeah.
And that's what he did. He came in there, he was just knocking people over to doing this, and they just stood there for like the next like four entries until Goldberg came in and just knocked him out.
Yeah, it was like,
what do you mean? Like,
well, it's like he hits a spear on Lesnar. Lesnar does this typically, you know, he sells it, you know, really good, and then he stands up and like looks at Goldberg, and Goldberg just eliminates him, and then it's like, well, Lesnar comes in and he tears through everybody that's in the ring, so Goldberg ought to just start grabbing people, you know what I'm saying?
Like, exactly. I mean, theoretically. Like that's why, like, psychologically, like they have no psychology behind this like Goldberg and Lesnar feud. You let Lesnar tear through your whole roster, just beating everybody like that, and then Goldberg comes back and beats him. So why isn't Goldberg the champ?
Goldberg should be unstoppable.
Yeah, it's like
physically unstoppable.
It's like why wouldn't he be champion? And I know they won't do that, but it's like
I'm tired of this. Like when Goldberg came back, if everybody remembers back in.
It was like November.
October, November, whatever it was. First week of November. You know, Paul Heyman comes out and he's, you know, Lesnar challenges Goldberg to a fight, you know, all this stuff. And they had their Survivor Series match. And then on Raw Monday night, the same exact thing happened. Paul Heyman and Lesnar come out.
He did kind of
I'm challenging you to a fight
though.
At WrestleMania. It's like...
It was interesting, though. Like,
it was an interesting
promo.
He
hit on, like, sometimes, like, a guy just has a guy's number. Sometimes... A guy's a legend. He has his number, all that.
But I feel like I'm.
But it's like
I feel like
we're kind of doing it
again.
Yeah.
Like it's exactly what it feels like. It's like, okay, how many times is Lesnar going to challenge Goldberg to a fight? And then
I don't want him.
And then I'm sitting. Yeah.
As fast as he does.
It's one thing if he loses.
He cannot. He can't lose again to Goldberg.
It's like, almost like when
he's not gonna be wrestling.
It's almost like when Zack Ryder kept getting beat up by Kane, like that storyline. Remember that?
Yeah, exactly.
And it's like everybody's behind Zack Ryder, and it's same thing with Ziggler. And then you get a guy that everybody likes, and he keeps losing, and he keeps losing, and he doesn't do anything about it. It's one thing if he loses, he doesn't even do anything about it. It's like you're getting a character, and it's like, who's gonna cheer for a guy who doesn't even do anything? He loses, and he just takes it.
Yeah,
it's like hard to get behind that character. And they do it with like Ziggler, Zack Ryder, Brock Lesnar. It's like we get behind this character and they just kill it for us.
It's ridiculous how like this is obviously going to take up a slot at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Goldberg's 50, so it's not going to last for more than I'll give it max
10 minutes.
Eight to ten minutes.
That's 20. You guys are really
no way.
Goldberg.
I mean, I don't
in his prime in his 30s he wouldn't go past like 10.
No, that's what I'm saying. I thought like max like
absolute max. Yeah.
Absolute like 20,
max 10.
15, 20. I was
8 to 10 is about as long as this thing's going to last. So you're taking up a whole WrestleMania slot, and it's not going to. max is 10 minutes, and it's not going to last 10 minutes.
It probably will. I think they might do a bunch of, like, really good sells, so they sit there and kill time, and they do the theatrics.
That's what I was thinking.
I think it'll take maybe 10 minutes, but it'll be, like, dragged out.
Personally, just a complete personal opinion on this, I would like to see them get in the ring, Lesnar suplexes him two times, hits him with an F5, and pins him.
I don't want that. I don't, like...
And then, like, just stands over him, doesn't pin him, stands there a couple minutes, and he lets him get up, hits him with another something.
See, like I want Lesnar to win, but even when Goldberg won, I was more mad that it was like a minute and 26.
Yeah.
Like, I hope Lesnar wins, but I don't even care if it like I'd rather it be like 10 minutes really for my own entertainment value, like, and have Goldberg even make a comeback. But like, generally, I just don't like a quick match.
Yeah,
like I don't like a high like stakes anticipated match.
They're making it like if Kane fought Hornswoggle. Like, that's how much he just dominated.
Honestly what they're making
him. And that's what's annoying. Like, Brock Lesnar is not going to get destroyed that fast by anybody.
I mean, it's one of those things, like, is it scripted? Yes, but, like, that's just ridiculous.
Brock Lesnar is one of those people that has so much legitimacy behind him. It's hard to make a WWE storyline.
Yeah, but it's like you can do it, but, like, you know, like, when The Undertaker beats him, I'm not mad about it.
Yeah, when Kurt
Angle beat him, I'm not mad. When Goldberg does it in a minute and 26, I'm like, that's so stupid. And he gets no vengeance back on him. That's really the problem.
Yeah, he just comes out in the Rumble and just throws him right over again. And it's like, Brock Lesnar, we know Brock Lesnar doesn't get beat. If he gets beat, it's not like that.
It's almost like he goes through the whole roster, and then Goldberg beats him, like, first try and then second try, and it's like... So you let this guy kill everybody on the roster, and then you're not consistent with it, and you let this 50-year-old guy come back for, like, one more match and beat him. It's like...
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, I don't know. It's so inconsistent. It's kind of...
As inconsistent as it can possibly be, but...
But overall, I'm excited for the road to WrestleMania. They have a lot of interesting things going on, though.
I do think the Royal Rumble was a very, very good Royal Rumble, though.
Oh, yeah. People were saying it was the worst.
And all the matches were good.
Yeah, people were saying it
the Charlotte Bailey match, it was good.
I liked it.
It was good.
Trust me, I'm pretty critical on the women's matches.
But they're getting legit.
They're getting better,
I mean, they're getting good.
Have, like, a well-thought-out match now. It's not just, like, 5 years ago, like, let Nikki Bella go over.
Like, I think the worst match on the card was the Neville match, and it was still a really good match.
It was pretty good.
I didn't like seeing it end in a submission, but...
That was kind of lame, yeah. I thought that was...
Cruiserweights ending in a submission is kind of...
What was the next one?
Roman and
Kevin. I'm just tired of that storyline. I think it's stale as can be. I hope it's over.
But I think it is. But the match performance...
The match was great. Like, it's not even the guy's fault. It's just like...
The WWE is forcing Roman...
They're putting Roman in a spot where he can't be liked.
I like Roman Reigns, and I still like him even in the title picture. I really like him too. I really like him, and it's like the whole Universal title match, I was really excited. I'm like, man, they're putting on a good match. Even if Roman loses, I'm okay with it. Then Braun Strowman comes in, whatever, anything. And I'm like, okay, Roman lost, but I'm still happy. I'm still a Roman Reigns fan. And then he comes out in the Rumble number 30, and I'm like...
That wasn't even his fault.
It wasn't the worst part about the Rumble. And that's not hit exactly.
The worst part is Roman, they're doing the same exact thing they did with Cena. He has a lot of talent, and he doesn't have nearly as much charisma as Cena. That's one reason people are mad. But it's like, he's not as bad as people say, and they don't give him a break. They put him in 30, and it's not the fact that Roman was in it. It's the fact that people were hoping Kenny Omega or Kurt Angle or Finn Balor or...
They got their hopes up for this surprise
injury.
Yeah.
I heard even rumors Rey Mysterio. And you have all these possibilities. Kenny Omega, I think I said him. You got all these possibilities. And then you, not only do you not bring him in, but you make Roman be the guy who has to
It could have been Nakamura.
It could have been anybody.
Samoa Joe, you freaking brought him in the next night.
Yeah, that
Why
was
didn't
lazy.
You just let him come in 30? Like, he's not, Roman didn't win. What's the difference in bringing in Samoa Joe and not letting him win?
The problem is, it's not even the fact that Roman came in. It's just like, people are mad that, A, their guy didn't, one of their surprise entrants didn't come in, and B, it's because Roman took their spot.
One of the least liked guys.
Exactly,
yeah. It's like, why are you going to put Roman in that corner? You're trying to get him over and you make him do that? And then I hear Triple H on these podcasts, like, I don't know why they're booing Roman. They just need to... It's like, dude, why would you do that? Like,
you're forcing him on us.
Yeah,
we don't like
it. It's your fault for doing that. That's
they're shoving him down our throats.
Yeah, give him... If he has one match on the card, I can get into the Roman Reigns character.
Exactly.
If he has one... Because when he has one match on the card, that Universal title match was... In my opinion, the second best singles match on the card. Which, I mean, there was
And if you
four,
think about it, like, if this was for real, why would you let a guy have a title match and then put him in the Rumble where he can also win another title match? Like, I know he didn't win, but, like, psychologically, why would you do that?
Yeah, you gotta give it to someone else, but...
And why would you let him in?
I'm gonna be talking out of both sides of my mouth here. I'm a Roman Reigns fan, but thank God he didn't win the Rumble, because the Cena Orton storyline is a way better storyline, I think.
Although people are gonna complain to Cena Orton like 10,000, but I mean, it's like
they're both on the heels of their career. They got to realize like it's different than
they've done it a lot, but it's been good.
Yeah. It's different. It's different from 8 years ago.
I mean, really, people are saying they do it all the time, but I mean, they did it in 07. I think they did it in like 2010 or 11 once or twice. It was like
2009, 2010.
2013, yeah. They did it, and that's really the last time we've seen it.
That's really, yeah, but because then that's when the Lesnar thing.
They had that match at Hell in a Cell in 2014, too. But I mean, that wasn't a title match. That was a one off match, and they didn't even
this have this is a WrestleMania.
They've never WWE had a one on one WrestleMania either.
One on one WrestleMania title match. This is, yeah. We've never seen this before. Guys, WrestleMania is a different animal than Hell in a Cell and Elimination Chamber and SummerSlam. It's a whole different animal.
And also, like, the one time they did do it, they had Triple H, and Triple H just forced his way into the triple threat, main event, and just ruined the whole thing. That was 40, so lame.
Cena's 40, Orton's what, 38?
Well, Orton's a little bit younger because he got in, 04, he won the title 24. That was in 04, so he's, you know, he's like 38.
Yeah, 38, something like that. So, these guys are, I don't want to say they're on
39, maybe. Yeah.
They're kind of on the downward slope. They're on the decline of their.
I mean, they could wrestle for 5 or 6 more years, but they've wrestled for 15. We know they've wrestled
for
15.
I feel like this is going to be both of their last title match at WrestleMania, I think. Very bold prediction.
I think Vince might have another thought about that. Very people were saying prediction. That like a long time ago, and he has one now, though.
But I feel like Vince is going to at least go out there and be like, hey, guys, this could be y'all's last WrestleMania title match.
It's definitely the last time they'll face each other.
Cut loose. It's WrestleMania, give us what you got.
And then it's kind of like our generation's, like, two guys that, like, you know, like, every generation
has, for
like,
us, this
like
is
the
our
Brett
guy.
Sean, like, the Austin Rock.
We're the Orton Cena.
Yeah, we have Orton Cena, like, and they're pretty good together, really. I mean, they can always, it's kind of like, you know, when they don't know what to do, and that could be part of the reason people don't like it, because it might have just been like,
it's a lot of filler, but, I mean.
You know, let's just throw them in together. They haven't had a match in a while. They haven't had a program in a long time, and they're kind of like our generation's two guys that can always go together. And it is kind of like our Brett Shawn and our Brock Austin. It's always good when they do it.
And it's lasted a long, long time.
And they're on SmackDown, too. And I don't know if people probably know, like, the SmackDown promos, they have a lot more leeway.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if it was on Raw, I could see exactly what they're talking about. It'd be stale. On SmackDown, they could kind of do, like the shots. Like, you know, you get pushed by Vince, and then he can be like, well, you got as much opportunity as I had, Randy, and you just, early in your career, you didn't take it seriously. I can see him doing all that kind of stuff.
Okay, so WrestleMania title match. Let's just say that's what happened, because that's what's going to happen. Cena Orton, who you taking?
It'll probably be Cena.
Cena?
I don't know. I think it could be Orton because he has the Wyatt family.
I think Orton.
Orton. I think Orton's going to turn on the Wyatt family.
I don't think he'll do that with his match against Cena.
I think
he's going to do it at Elimination Chamber. Because they're both, Bray and Orton are both in it.
I think they'll dominate
already. Oh, really?
Yeah, they're both in it. So I feel like it's going to come down
to
Cena, Bray, and Orton. And then Bray's going to get out. I think Cena will get out, maybe, somehow. And then I think it'll be like a Orton, Bray, and somebody. Orton's not just going to.
I think Bray will hit Cena or do something to Cena, and then Orton will just turn on him just RKO.
I thought for just a second in the Rumble, it really looked like Orton.
They always tease that Rumble, like,
I thought he was going to do it, and I was like, that was close.
I don't know if they don't do it at Elimination Chamber. I think they'll do it after WrestleMania.
I think they'll ride the Wyatt family to WrestleMania.
You think so?
Because I think they're gonna want to. Because I think they know people are gonna just automatically say Cena goes over Orton, and they want people to go, well, I don't know, because he's coming in there with Bray Wyatt, and Bray Wyatt can hit him in the back, and then sort of Cena hits RKO or Orton gets RKO, and you know they want you to guess.
Who would you like to see if Kevin Owens takes the title all the way to Mania, which I think he will.
I think he will. I thought that before. People are saying he'd drop it at Rumble. I was like, yeah, right.
Who would you like to see him face at Mania? Because Owens is a good performer. He's a really good performer.
He's good, but I think his title reign has been extremely stale. I know all the internet fans are not going to like that.
It is stale.
I think they were just...
Every single match. I was thinking about this today.
It's always a false finish, not even, like, clever.
Even when he won it. False finish. Even when he won it.
Yeah.
He hasn't cleanly...
I mean, I know he's a heel, but, like, when Rollins was a heel or Edge or, like, the great heels, they win in different ways. Like, he wins the same way.
It's... Yeah.
He was supposed to cheat. I get that. But, like, he does it the same
and
way.
And I enjoyed...
It's not even good heat. It's like, I'm tired of watching this
when
heat.
When he won it with the Triple H pedigree on Rollins, I liked that. I was like...
Yeah, I liked it initially. I remember we watched that.
I was freaking out. I was like, this is awesome how he just won that. And then it's like, Jericho helps him win. And then Jericho helps him win. And then Jericho helps him win. And I'm like, okay, I'm getting tired of this. Well, finally they put Jericho in a shark cage. I'm like, maybe there might be a real
fight. I was like, nope, no. Whenever
I was like,
they
there
do
might
that,
actually...
No.
The little bit of hope I have.
I told you they wouldn't do that.
He even dropped the brass knuckles, so he even...
Yeah, I mean, he even dropped the brass knuckles, and I was like, gosh, man, like, this is ridiculous.
I told you, I said, whenever they do that, when they take a measure to not let a guy cheat, he's going to cheat.
Then Braun
Every
Strowman...
Every time, it's always happening.
Braun Strowman comes out, and I was like, gosh, man, like, he has not... Still to this day, he has not cleanly won that title, even when he initially won it.
Even when everybody complained about Rollins' title run... 2 years ago, I loved it.
He had some clean wins.
He had clean wins, and he put on 5-star matches, like, all the time. So you can't really... Owens, he's a good wrestler, but I'm just saying, he's not Rollins.
Nah.
He's a great wrestler. Don't get me wrong. He can move like no, like, big man can, like, his size. But can he do the things Rollins could do in 40-minute matches?
I think the best thing for Owens at Mania would be Finn Balor with a win. Finn Balor winning
the... You want him to win if he does do that?
If it comes down, I think it's going to
be... I don't think they'll let him go over Finn Balor. He was white.
No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. I think it's going to be... Because Finn Balor is like... He was almost ready for the Rumble. He was barely not ready.
Yeah, he really...
He probably could have went out 30 and like eliminated one person, took a quick little bump, and then got eliminated. You know what I mean?
He was white hot over the summer, too.
And I'm saying he is... I know for a fact he's going to be ready for Mania.
Yeah, that was like SummerSlam, right?
Let him come back two Raws before WrestleMania. Come out.
No, that's a little thrown together, though.
Come out. Don't take any bumps. Don't get hurt. Come out. Cut some promos on, you know, almost like a Rollins. Like, I never lost my title, you know, like.
I liked it when he did that. Yeah,
I never lost my title, and then he could be like, you know, I want my rematch, and I want it at Mania against Owens, because, you know. We're the only two people that's ever even held this title, and he's only holding it because
they have a rich
it has some history. Good, like, yeah. So, I'd like to see Finn Balor take the title off of Owens at Mania. And I feel like they could put on a really good match. They've really been good through the indies. They've ran into each other.
They can do the whole, we've been wrestling each other for 10 years before we got here. They'll like to do that, like, for a good storyline. They'll be like, they'll hint towards we weren't always in WWE. They only do that for, like, really good feuds.
Yeah, I think those two guys can pull it off. I think they can pull that
SmackDown
off.
SmackDown-wise, like, they're going to do Orton Cena at WrestleMania, right?
Orton Cena, WrestleMania. I wouldn't mind seeing
AJ Styles thrown in the mix. I normally don't like triple threats, but, like, when Triple H and the Orton and Cena one, that one was just thrown together at the last minute. This one, they could really get ahead.
I wouldn't mind seeing... Because I think he's the kind of character and the kind of athlete that deserves it. But if AJ Styles got the Intercontinental title, I wouldn't be upset about that. He's a real good technical wrestler.
I think he was a perfect. Like I was saying, like we were saying, Owens' title run was stale. I did not think AJ Styles was stale.
That was good.
I like him a lot.
I'm just saying traditionally.
That's my favorite wrestler ever.
He's the epitome of IC champion.
I mean,
the guy who can put on the best match. The guy who's really the workhorse.
Yeah.
Almost really, like, could probably be the world champion, but they need him in that spot.
And he could elevate that title for a little bit. I mean,
oh, yeah. You throw that title on him, and, you know, the value can go up. The only problem is when they do that, they don't continue to do it. The U.S. title, like, they gave it to Cena, they let it get, like, a lot of worth. Then they just, what is it now?
Jericho.
Nobody cares now.
46-year-old Jericho.
Which I like him being the U.S. champion, but I mean, even before Jericho won it, it wasn't like, you know, they gave it to Roman, like, just because they didn't know what to do with him.
And Rusev.
Yeah, that's the problem.
And Rollins held it.
And the IC title, they did the same thing. They did the they let Daniel Bryan have it that like 2 years ago at WrestleMania, and it was like, okay, this title was worth something. And then what is it now?
The Miz, and I mean, Dean Ambrose is good, but he's not a good wrestler.
He's a good wrestler, but he's not like the IC is like like your Shawn Michaels,
the Ziggler's,
like,
the Shawn Michaels,
the
AJ
Bret Hart's
Styles.
Like that's the guy I wanted to be.
Yeah,
the IC
they're
title.
Technically probably the best wrestler.
They really like the best wrestler. Like all the other wrestlers will say they're the best, but they don't sell as much merch, and they're not going to be like bringing people.
So
in
I mean,
much.
I wouldn't be upset with an AJ Styles IC title run. That wouldn't.
I think
that
would be pretty cool, actually. I mean, I just think I want to see him get his rematch. Whether
I'd
he
like
wants
to see him IC and heavyweight. To be honest, I mean, I think holding it's, both.
When
cool.
Rollins did that was pretty cool.
It'd
I like
be cool.
That was historic. I like that.
Who would you like to see?
I don't know. I think the triple threat would be awesome. That way, number one, it's not the old John Cena and Orton just them two. That way, it's like, oh, there's AJ Styles too. That way, nobody's like,
we would have thought like 10 years ago, like there's gonna be Orton, Cena, and people would be like, okay, I believe that. Oh, and AJ Styles all in a match together.
That would be. Oh my god, I would. I don't even know.
It's what so weird seeing like Samoa Joe and like AJ Styles and all these guys.
I guess if Samoa Joe attacked him, maybe he would have a WrestleMania match, but. Since he likes to hurt people.
Let's just say Rollins doesn't make it for WrestleMania, which is really probably sadly a possibility. What are they going to do with like the Triple H, Samoa Joe, Rollins storyline? What are they going to do? Scrap the whole thing?
I mean, if Rollins is hurt, you as bad as it sounds, you have to. You could let Rollins come out on like some crutches next Monday night on Raw and cut a promo. Because I'm assuming that was Samoa Joe's Raw debut. I'm assuming that's what that was. If I had to just take a stab in the dark, I'm assuming Samoa Joe is no longer on NXT, he's on Raw.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
So, you can start a legitimate feud between Samoa Joe and Rollins. Let him just cut a promo on Samoa Joe in the ring, while he's leaning on his crutches. Like,
I feel like they're going to throw him together, Roman.
Way to go, I missed WrestleMania last year, and it was my fault. This time it's Samoa Joe's fault, and as soon as I'm back, you know. Me and you.
But, I mean, that's over then. Like, they can't do anything.
Well, they can't do it until he comes back.
Back.
I mean, we don't know how long he'll be gone.
This won't happen, probably, but this is what I've really been hoping. Everybody knows Samoa Joe was in TNA and, like, you know, all the Ring of Honor and all that stuff.
Never happened.
I'm just saying, like, he was always tight with, like, CM Punk and all those guys. What if he just somehow talked Vincent and just, because I heard he said it on a podcast, CM Punk. He wants one more match, and he probably only wants it with somebody like Samoa Joe.
Oh, man.
What if he was like, can I just bring CM Punk back? I need a WrestleMania opponent. Rollins, he's not going to be able to make it. What are they going to do, throw me together? They probably will just throw him together with Roman or somebody like that. But what would be better than him? CM Punk won't come back unless he gets to come back with like one of his guys he really likes.
It could be cool to see, like let's say Rollins' injury isn't so, so bad. Like let's say he could take like a very light bump, a very, very light bump. What if he, like, comes out on Raw, you know, Samoa Joe hurt me, whatever, all that nonsense, and Samoa Joe comes out, puts him in some kind of, I don't know, just does some kind of thing to him, and like...
His heat goes up, like...
Yeah, his heat, tremendous. His heat flies, and since he's already lost the NXT Championship, Shinsuke Nakamura comes out and defends Rollins.
That would be cool.
That'd be cool.
Because you got a guy that hot, like, his heat is up so high, like, people are just mad, they don't even care if it's Rollins, they just want to see
him. Especially since he hurt him.
Yeah.
They're like, dude, like, Rollins was, like...
I mean, and backstage, he's not going to be... Nobody's going to be happy about it, but he can go out on Raw next week, and for his character, he can be like, I came in 5 minutes, I made impact, nobody else can make. I put Rollins out. He can do all that.
Yeah, and let him come out and give Rollins a quick little bump, and Shinsuke...
That would make people furious.
Shinsuke's music hits, he comes flying down the ramp, attacks Samoa Joe, because they've had some... awesome NXT matches.
And they've been using the NXT, like, I remember back in the day, they would like, when NXT first got popular, like, once you got to WWE, whatever you did in NXT didn't happen. Like, we don't care.
Yeah,
no. Now they'll be like, oh, yeah, me and you went out at NXT, and I'm not done with you. They do all that kind of, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn kind of.
Yeah. So I think that'd be cool. If once again, this is if Rollins can't make WrestleMania, and if this is not.
Which it looks like he might not, because it looked.
And if.
The picture he put up looked kind of serious,
And if this isn't storyline, I mean...
I don't think they'd go this far with it.
You never know the WWE,
but you can kind of tell, like, you once you've been watching so long, like, we can.
So, I think Lesnar has to go over Goldberg. He has to.
You just killed the Brock Lesnar character.
I think Kevin Owens has to lose the title at Mania.
Extremely stale.
It'd be awesome if he loses to Finn Balor.
That's probably why they let Cena go over, because... They're probably gonna wait till Kevin Owens loses at WrestleMania, and they're like, we gotta do a title change. We can't have two champions holding it this long, and they're both heels.
Yeah.
We need something for somebody.
I'd like to see Kevin Owens lose it to Finn Balor. I don't know if I want Orton taking the title off of Cena.
No, they won't. I don't think they'll do that.
I don't think they will, but...
Those are the three majors at WrestleMania.
I think a younger guy will take it away. I don't think they're gonna... What are you gonna do, like, let a new guy lose it? Like, I know... Styles is old, but he's still a new guy. Let him lose it to Cena, and then Cena gives it to Orton. It's like, you've got three older guys having it. Like,
so I think...
Kevin Owens isn't really young either.
I mean, he's like 35.
I mean, you gotta eventually... Yeah. Somebody has to get a... Some younger guy has to get it.
Finn Balor's not young. That's the thing. People don't know that. Finn Balor's like 33. I mean...
Yeah.
I mean, he's got a really good 7 years left.
This is like... that was the problem with CM Punk, too. Cena gave up the title to him, but... CM Punk's older than John Cena.
Yeah, oh yeah. So, I mean, you got an interesting WrestleMania. We'll have to just keep watching Raw and keep watching SmackDown to further our...
Yeah.
You know,
we can do more videos like this.
Yeah, we'll have to get more storyline, especially with the Rollins injury thing, because that there's a really big, like, problem in the storyline.
That could really seriously mess up a I guarantee he got yelled out backstage.
Probably.
He did it for 5 minutes.
Especially when he has to walk and like Vince is within like.
Well, he has to go back through Gorilla, and Vince is sitting in Gorilla on Raw.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
he probably got screamed at.
He's like, dude, I let you go out there for 5 minutes and you hurt arguably our best star. Like, what are you doing?
He is the dude who is going to carry the company, and you just completely hurt him.
And I was talking about
Samoa Joe's an old, like, he's not, he's like the AJ Styles age. Like, he's not a young guy.
Like, me and him were talking about those. I remember people were kind of freaking out when Rollins, you know, he kneed John Cena and broke his nose.
Yeah, then he hurt Singh.
Then he hurt Finn Balor. Then he got hurt himself.
They were like, dude.
Now he got hurt again. They're probably like, there's 5 injuries with you in the mix.
Yeah.
Vince doesn't like that. I don't know, like, they're not going to not give him the ball anymore, but they might have to kind of make him earn his stripes or whatever you want to call it again.
Give him the U.S. title again.
Yeah. It's kind of sad, really, because I feel like they're going to kind of start losing faith in him a little bit.
So I think we can, I love doing WWE videos. They're my favorite, because it can really go
anywhere. Well, it's not like NFL, okay, this team's better than them. Like, you can kind of go off, like, and think about, you know, things.
There's so many different angles you can have, and there's no right angle until it happens.
Yeah, I mean.
There's no, I don't think that could happen, because anything can happen in the WWE.
Yeah, anything's possible.
I mean, I've seen Hornswoggle win the Cruiserweight Championship.
That's a problem.
All right. So that was pretty good. That was fun. We'll try to do as many WWE videos as can. I don't want to promise one every week, but we're going to try.
Whenever there's something relevant and, you know, we have, like, depending on when our last one was, we'll have one, like, periodically.
Not as often as the NFL, but we could do at least, I feel like we can promise one every 2 weeks. And every now and then, you know, it'll be a weekly basis thing. So
with the road to WrestleMania, we could probably manage one every week.
Yeah, we can probably handle that. Then SummerSlam will be like, here I come. So, all right, well, that was pretty fun. Thanks for watching this. If you want our t-shirts, we forgot to wear our t-shirts today, I know, but we want to do a WWE video, and I wanted to wear my AJ Styles shirt. Thanks for watching, everybody. Check out everything on social media. We'll see you next time.